So my name is Dr. Maggie Aderin-Pocock, and I'm a space scientist and a science communicator. Well, space scientist, I actually build satellites that go up in space. And science communicator, I like to try and translate some of the complexity of science into a simple format for everybody to understand. Someone somewhere will think we need a satellite to understand the universe, to probe the Earth's atmosphere, or to do something. At Astrium Limited, what I do is we take that requirement and we try and build instrumentation and a complete satellite system that will meet those requirements. So my PhD was in mechanical engineering, but before that I did my degree, which was in physics. And so that was quite an interesting hybrid for me, because doing the physics and the mechanical engineering turned out to be a perfect marriage for making satellites in the future. I didn't know it at the time, but it worked out very well. So I sort of had an inkling that I was quite likely to go into industry, because I like to solve problems and actually take the physics and the mechanical engineering that I'd learned and put them onto a variety of different problems. But when I actually left university, I wasn't actually sure where I was going to go. And also jobs were very scarce at the time, but I actually found a job with a branch of the Ministry of Defence, the Defence Evaluation Research Council, and was doing and making instrumentation for them. The first sort of instrumentation I was working on was something called a missile warning system. And this was a sort of quite a complex piece of equipment. But what it was designed to do was warn pilots when a missile was coming and then automatically let off flares to protect the pilot and the aircraft. So I did that for a number of years and travelled around the world, went out to Australia, to Woomera, and did tests out there, as well as Pendine Sands in Wales. Then I actively got a promotion and I changed to working in landmine detection. That was my first management role, and I was managing a handheld landmine detection group. From there, I actually actively decided that I'd come back to academia, because my dream had always been to sort of work in space and astronomy. And as a child, my very first instrument that I made was my own telescope. So an opportunity came up to work on the Gemini telescope in South America. And this is an 8-metre telescope. And I did that role at UCL, University College London. And we were building an instrument that bolted onto the telescope. So we spent sort of 2.5 years building an instrument in UCL in the basement. And then it was a fantastic day when we packed it all up and shipped it out to Chile. And then I spent about 6 months working in South America. And then from that, I got my dream of actually working in space science. And that's why I transferred from making ground-based telescopes to space-based telescopes and space-based instrumentation. Because I think for me, and it took me a while to realise, the core for my PhD wasn't just the technical knowledge that I picked up, but it was also the transferable skills, which you don't really see at the time. But it's things like problem solving, taking on a challenge, getting it down to sort of the nitty-gritty, and working out a step-by-step method of solving a problem. To me, space was the ultimate goal. And I think it was sort of subconscious for a long time, but I could see I had that sort of goal in mind. And so when I took on jobs, it was all saying, well, you know, can they lead me to space? You know, will it go a different way? And it didn't matter that I did lots of different things on the way, because I think often that helps. But that was, I think, my goal. Because I've had sort of quite a hybrid career, there are benefits in working in academia and pitfalls, and the same in industry. But I think I've done it sort of in a slightly strange way, where I'm doing both now, and sort of trying to get the benefits of both aspects and minimise the detriments. And it's not something that people often consider, but there are some good benefits in doing both. Sometimes it means you don't know what hat you're wearing on what day, but there are synergies between the two. Someone once told me that you don't actually, for the time extra time you spend in university doing a PhD, you don't actually get the money back until you're 40. But I think you can actually get it back sooner than that.